Are we going to see another wave of foreclosures? Today, we're going to set the record straight. Hey, Scott Himelstein with the Scott Himelstein Group. You know, somebody asked me earlier this week if I thought, due to the fact that interest rates have spiked in the last 8 to 9 months, if I believed that we were going to be seeing a foreclosure wave or foreclosure boom. And I thought this would be a good opportunity to really address that, because according to media reports, foreclosure filings doubled in the United States in 2022. Now, this is an alarming statistic, and it may have people wondering if we're in for another wave of foreclosures. But when you really take a closer look at the data and putting things into perspective, I think it's really essential. So first, while doubling of foreclosure filings may sound like a significant increase, it's important to remember that it's nowhere near the levels we saw during the housing market crash of 2008. And in fact, in some areas across the country, the number of foreclosures in 2022 was either meager or non-existent. So, you know, let's dive in a little further into the numbers. So in 2022, the foreclosures, which were default notices, foreclosure filings, scheduled auctions, bank repossessions, they were up 115% from 2021 nationwide. But it was down 34% from 2019 before the pandemic really shook up the marketplace. And foreclosure filings in 2022, this is the important stat to keep in mind, we're also down 89% from a peak of nearly 2.9 million in 2010. So I think one reason is that homeowners today obviously have a lot more equity than ever before. And in addition, many people currently in the market, they've taken advantage of the historically low interest rates, whether to buy or to refinance their mortgages and build up their equity. And that means that even if they faced financial difficulties, they would still have a significant cushion to protect themselves from foreclosure. And I think another important factor is that lending standards have become stricter in recent years. And before the housing market crash, it was easy for people to obtain mortgages they could not afford. And that really led, obviously, to a flood of foreclosures. And then when the market turned, it really ended up becoming a disaster for the country. So today, lenders are much more careful about whom they lend to and require a much stricter set of documentation and financial qualifications. So this really helps ensure that only people can truly qualify are actually able to buy a home. All right, but let's talk a little bit more about LA County as well as the state of California. So, you know, the state of California has almost 15 million properties. That includes single family houses, townhomes, condos, etc. So it's obviously one of the most populous states in the entire country. And when you look at the amount of homes that are actually in foreclosure in January here of 2023, it was only less than 1,700 total in the state of California, again, of 15 million homes. It's about 14.8 to be exact, 14.8 million. And then when you come to LA County and you look even closer, LA County had its biggest jump of foreclosures between August and September of last year, where it went from 515 filings all the way up closer to 800. And I have a theory about that, why LA County is actually one of the biggest hotspots for foreclosures in the state of California. Now, obviously, number one, being the most populous county, having the most properties in the county, that's number one. But I think it's a lot bigger and deeper than that. And I think it comes down to the fact that LA County and the city of Los Angeles had a moratorium on evictions during the pandemic. And that's finally coming to an end here in both LA County and the city. And so a lot of those restrictions have gone away already this month. So you're talking about landlords that have not received any type of money for themselves to be able to pay the mortgage for 2 to 3 years in a lot of cases. And so as a result, a lot of them may actually have had to file for a foreclosure. All right, so that gives you an idea of why I think you're not going to be seeing a foreclosure boom. Now, if you're an investor hoping for this foreclosure market to rekindle, I think you're going to be severely disappointed. But if you're a homeowner and just worried that you don't want to see more foreclosures in the marketplace, I don't think you have anything to worry about. The data definitely supports that. Any real estate questions, feel free to give me a call. You're always welcome to shoot me an email or a DM as well. Thanks so much for watching our vlog.